I am annoyed at politics today, David.
That's a new one.
Yeah, exactly. It's a new feeling for me, but actually, it's very it's a feeling I've felt before. I'm having a little bit of a deja vu moment because, well, earlier in the day, a group of Democrats came out and said Ilhan was too mean about Israel and America, saying that they could be at all put in the same sentence as Hamas, which Israel helped fund because they wanted to marginalize the PLO, and they prefer that because of exactly these sorts of "you support terrorists" shenanigans. And so, if you recall, last time the Democrats wanted to roll out a big democracy bill, HR 1 under Trump, the same week, Nancy Pelosi decided she needed to reprimand Ilhan Omar about the All About the Benjamins comment, and that completely swamped any sort of movement on that. And a good thing, because it's not like that would have came in handy, you know, to be unified around that as a party for a while. And so fast forward to the Biden administration and realizing we're not going to get any sort of democracy reform protections or anything because Joe Manchin doesn't want to be part of the efforts, and also signaling he won't do filibuster reform, so PRO Act won't bother with that. Any major structural legislation not going to be done. So what did the Democrats decide to do? Well, let's police Ilhan Omar's language some more. There's another point to be made, which is that Betsy McCollum, a representative in St. Paul, Minnesota, has actually very similar statements, almost identical. Because let's not pretend Ilhan's really out there lobbing bombs, right? What she said was completely the nature.
No, in fact, I don't mean to cut you off, but like, in fact, I remember when she first made that statement, seeing people, you know, on like the anti-imperialist left being angry at Ilhan for how like muted her comments were, and actually were angry at her for equivocating Hamas with the United States.
Precisely,
Israel.
Right? You have people criticized from the left saying, why are you even bringing up Hamas? Because really the force of violence is clearly just the balance. If you just fucking weighed the bombs and munitions, right? Mm-hmm. And never mind like the deaths, which also tell exact same story. That's a very good point. And so Ilhan said a point that has been going around, which is where do Palestinians get accountability for these actions? And Secretary of State Blinken is like, well, America and Israel, just go to them. And the absurdity of that is just obvious on its face.
And I just want to add to that, you know, specifically about the justice system in Israel, particularly for people who are in, you know, occupied territories. You have conviction rates there that hover, you know, in the upper 90%, right? Like 98%, 99%, meaning that like if you get accused of a crime, you're very likely going to be, you know, sentenced. Even worse than that, the backlog of this court system is so bad. And because people were typically held until they have their trial date, that most people, just because they know it's going to be quicker to just, you know, plead guilty in advance rather than go to trial. Because if they wait for trial, they're going to have to be waiting sometimes as many, you know, as like 3-5 years to be able to have their date in court, right? This is not a court system that anybody should uphold as a system of you know, functioning democracy or rule of law or anything like that. This is something that's very much imposed to continue the apartheid system against Palestinian people.